just got a little bit of steel coming out.
Well, this is our new rigid. It didn't, it all came together for $300. So we think we did pretty good, but it's certainly not new price. Man, new, these things are pricey.
You know, we were using metric degrees. Didn't come out right.
Just pull the trigger.
So, lift this up.
Putting in a sea chest.
Hit it with your head and held it away.
An inch. Okay, DC voltage. Let's see what we got.
That looks
dead. Dead. Am I on the right thing? Yeah, I am. Hey, there's 0.8 volts. Most of these are as flat as can be. There's a little bit. But the beautiful thing about this type of battery, this nickel iron battery, is that you can run them completely flat. And you don't do much damage to the battery, and these have drained off slowly, so I think they're going to be fine. All right, well, the way it's worked out is the batteries are going to fit beautifully into the storage tanks in the hole here. That one was going to be a bathtub, so we can't use it for a bathtub anymore. So instead, we're going to put a bottom in this hatch area up here. That's a little tight. You're going to need to trim some. But what he's doing is getting a cardboard template made and cut a piece of steel tomorrow to put in there to make the bottom of our bathtub. So there's our batteries, and we can fortunately get 30 of those in each of these wells. We only have 57 of them. We're going to put a flat bottom in there, and then if we need to, we'll put lead bars down below there to increase our ballast should we need to. And Hollis and been back here working on everything's closed, so we can't get pipe fitting. So he's working on the what we call this, a sea chest. And it's harder to walk through here without the floor anymore. And so he's scribing, rough cut it, and now he's scribing a line around it to get a really nice cut against the hull. And then we'll put a big bevel on it. Yeah, it is an inch off, isn't it?
Yep.
And then weld it in tomorrow. Got the little piece already welded on the inside, so a screen will go down inside of it and fit around that little piece he's already welded in there. Come up to this, and this is above the water line so that we can take the top off, clean out crap in there. Yeah, pull that screen out. It's got room to miss the companionway there. And that's the plan.
But you know, looking at it now, what did we see?
Yeah, it's way above the water line.
So something we definitely
which is good, because when we get heavily loaded down, I mean, it'd be nice to be able to have no fear. We really don't have a lot of stuff that's going to be fed off the sea chest. It'll mainly be the sink up in the galley. Will have, you
know, your biggest thing on most boats is your engine.
The engine, and the engine skeg cools, right, so it won't be part of it. But we could have, you know, live wells or something like that on board. And we could pull the salt water from that up there. So you think as low as possible that way?
I thought so, but
that's
then,
a lot of air column there.
It's not going to be air column though.
Oh, the water level, the water table will be. Yeah, our water table. What's it called? It's called the water line. And then, yeah, okay. That's not near the frame that comes up down there.
The frame comes about right there.
Oh, it's only to here.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that's fine.
Yeah. Trying to keep it as low as possible too, right? In the water.
Yeah.
Table.
Yeah. Table.
And then.
Oh, that's a nice bevel. Yep. Then what?
And then I thought maybe we'd put a little 3/4 blowout.
On the side of it?
On the top, you know, where you could just, if you wanted to hook your compressed air to it.
Oh, right, right, to blow crap back through it.
I want to use Schedule 80 on there. Oh, do you want to use stainless?
I'd like to use stainless or Schedule 80.
Who's got a piece of stainless?
I don't have either. That's why we wear boots.
Oh, yeah. These are my high-tech leather.
Yeah, high-tech safety shoes. I can see the hole in the toe there.
Yeah.
Well, our crane died again today, so we think it's a switch. So Lawrence here got creative and moved the wheels out of the way so we can get the other crane fast.
I like creative mechanical engineers. It's a nice thing.
Why don't you check the plans before you start building that?
Can we do as-built?
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 I don't even know what that means.
You don't?
No. Is that important?
Yeah.
What's as-built?
As-built is...
So it means as you built it, that's how you take it?
Yeah. Sometimes you can't follow your plan or there's a little issue, so you have to go back and as-built.
I think we are the as-built boat.
What do you think?
Oh, hot.
So that's that.
Oh, the top part of it.
Top part of it.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
That's what it needed.
That's all it
is. Oh, yeah. Stretch out that one.
Oh, it goes that far, huh?
Yeah.
Wow, that's perfect.
It's been a very, very good, very hot day, but there's the bathroom floor in, so he got it right. He got the engineering right on that. He cut a... We didn't think it was going to go in for a little while. Let me show you what Hoss has been doing here. That is all done. There's the bottom end of it. He's got one piece there. We're going to go get some Schedule 80 pipe for that on Monday to weld in the pipes. But he made the lid up for it. Even has a fancy dancy handle on it. And later on, we may put some acrylic in there so we can actually see down and look at the filter. But we'll start off with this rig. And I got the ROV all together. I ripped my plastic in the tank, but the tank's filling back up with some water. We'll do some weight tests tomorrow. Show you the ROV. So there she is, all put together with the seals in it. And I didn't bother hooking up any of the electronics, but they're all in there, the battery's in there. So we'll get the weights right this time and see what we gotta do. What I'm thinking is we're just gonna extend this rail, because I kinda like having this on the unit, all the way down, and we'll make modular floats that can be slid back and forth on here so that we can add as much flotation as we need to make it balance out. Later on, I think we'll have one that has multiple tubes, and that way we can add on extra battery capacity. The aft end of the keel, and what he's done is he's spurred a hole in here for a fuel pickup the outside of the hatch because he wants to run it all hard.
Okay, I need to bend this thing probably 78 degrees and maybe 30 seconds.
Aggressive. What we do is go out and weld it down to a plate of steel. Yeah, okay.
Let's see what that looks like. Stick it in a hole.
Yeah. Sweet.